After last night's incredible victory against Lazio, Neil Lennon spoke to the press today for 10 minutes. He looked pretty tired. And I know that St Anthony on our side often asks why teams can't play Thursday until Saturday. And if you saw Neil Lennon's face today, you'd see why. He said he got to his bed sometime in the middle of the morning. I doubt he's had much sleep. So we'd then be expecting players to play tomorrow. Anyway, enough of me. This is Neil Lennon from today's pre-Motherwell press conference. Not that much chat about Motherwell.
At the grass.
Neil, after having a chance to reflect, how are you feeling now?
Not really had a chance to reflect. You know, we got in back in early hours of this morning. Obviously, one of feelings of immense pride and satisfaction and happiness. You know, the Europa group is now qualified, and that's a huge feather in a cap. But just the quality of performances over the four games has been absolutely fantastic, with the, you know, real icing on the cake of a performance last night to win and win in Italy for the first time. It speaks volumes for the personality of the squad now.
You've always backed the team and always told us what you felt they were capable of, but have you quite believed how well you've done so far in the Europa League group?
No, I didn't think we'll qualify as quickly, but they showed great resilience at times last night, and then, you know, real sort of character to come back into the game and quality. We played really well. Some of our football in the second half was outstanding, and some of the chances were created. So that pleases me when you have that possession away from home, and then you create the quality of chances that we were creating. That's a real step in the right direction. And then to score the winner when we did, you know, it's just the ice, like I said, the icing on the cake. And I have to pay a huge amount of credit to the supporters who were there last night. It felt, you know, for the first time really in my second spell here, it felt like real Celtic again. Like, you know, that love and that pride and that sort of rawness from the crowd and the connection with the players and the European tie. They helped the team enormously. We were a goal down early, and they just kept the noise and the tempo up for the players, and we was able to send them home really happy.
I know sometimes you never know how the other groups are going to work out, but how key is it for you guys now to win the group, given how well you've done so far?
I think it's it would be great try and finish with as many points as possible, but obviously with the huge amount of games we have between now and the break, it's, you know, imperative that we use the squad as well. And I think it's important to, you know, give some players game time at that level as well. So players who have maybe not had the chance to play, you know, will get the opportunity to play in some of these games without obviously overdoing it.
You know, you talked about the real connection that's back. When did you feel that similar feeling first time around?
That's a good question. On many occasions, but, you know, this time, I think, obviously, with the way I came in February, there's a disconnect, you know, because of the agitation with Brendan leaving, lost a great manager, and just that feeling of sort of disconnect between certain supporters and the club. But it was all there. It was all connected again last night. It was a real parade there last night, I have to say, and it felt like the old days for me, even as a player, you know, just that huge noise and that rhythm from the crowd and that, just that parade. And to send them home happy was probably as pleasing for me as winning the game, really, for the players.
You praised your players last night, you praised your players again today. You must take personal satisfaction, given what you just said about the connection back.
I take a huge amount of pride in it, but it's just, you know, like I said last night, it's a sum of all parts. You know, I've got a great coaching staff here. Young, dynamic, intelligent, and John and Damien. Obviously, Woodsy's been here for a while and does a great job with the goalkeepers. But Damien and John have, you know, we're three different personalities, but we're all, you know, very, very tight, and we know what we want from the group. And, you know, their work ethic is fantastic. And then my fitness coaches and the physios. So it is a real team effort that's been set in place here. And then the players themselves, they're the most important people at the club, really, and they are playing brilliantly.
given the way you've played against the calibre of opposition in this group, I guess who, regardless who you get drawn against, you feel you're capable of competing?
Yeah, it's a long way off, you know. In February, we'll have to gauge it then. You'll have the January window where hopefully we can maybe do a bit of business and strengthen even from what we have already. So at the minute, we're in a good place. You know, the form, the consistency, the level of performance, the intensity of the way we're playing, the pace and power of the team, and the defensive diligence of some of the players. I thought Julian was immense last night. Obviously, you know, not taking anything away from Fraser Foster, he was outstanding as well. So, again, we're talking about the sum of all parts of the team as well. You know, the back boys did their bit. Midfield has been unbelievable this season. And going forward, we are a threat against anyone. So, at the minute, we're just in a good place. We're in the moment, but that can all change, as we know.
Neil, great performance in Rome last night. The Rangers obviously getting a great result against Porto. How much of a shot in the arm was all this last night for Scottish football?
I have no idea. I mean, you guys can gauge that, you know, just from... from our point of view, you know, to break that hoodoo of, you know, not winning in Italy was really important. Gives the club that little bit of extra gravitas and the players that little bit of extra confidence, you know. And although we've qualified and we've guaranteed qualification, you know, we still want to finish the group strong if we can and just keep that momentum going, hopefully, into the new year. But it can't be any harm, that's for sure. And it's good for the reputation of the game here, which takes a battering sometimes overly. So I think it's good recognition for Scottish football.
I remember when you got that result against Barcelona 7 years ago, almost to the day. Was it Elton John messaged you? Has he been back in touch with last night?
He hasn't, no, but I got a hug off Rod. So, you know, he was absolutely ecstatic last night, as were, you know, many people in the crowd. It was a proud night, you know, and one to see ever. Obviously, we've got a big game coming up on Sunday, so, you know, we can park that now and look forward to a good atmosphere here on Sunday.
I was going to say, Neil, I mean, last night every single Celtic player stood up was counted. And do these players get better before your eyes in terms of producing these big performances, which obviously give them massive self-belief?
Yes. Yeah. You know, there's a good balance of experience and there's some youth in there as well. You know, you have to remember Edward's still only 21, but... you know, he was phenomenal again last night. And then you've got your experienced ones with Brown, you know, your El Hameds, you know, Johnny Hayes, who did a great job for us last night, Fraser, excuse me. So the balance of youth and experience is good. Got plenty of international experienced players as well. So there's no reason now to believe that we can't go and compete in these games. And, you know, the players are trusting what we're telling them, but they are the ones going out and implementing that, and they're doing it in a spectacular fashion. The quality of football we played, particularly in the second half, was unbelievable. I felt to go to a team who were bang in form, who had just beaten AC Milan, and take the game to them that way, it just shows real bravery, and that's what we wanted from them.
And you're doing it against teams, Neil, and clubs in Europe just now, at the high end, have got X amount of dosh, and when you're not that high, you're still punching above your weight, both on the pitch and monetary terms wise.
Well, I mean, Lazio are a big club. I think they've got aspirations of the Champions League this year. He's got, you know, quality players. But for us, you know, that's two games now. And I think we needed it. I think we needed the games. I think the fans needed the games. I think the players needed the games. And it's a real good barometer for us, you know, going forward in the season in terms of the quality of the opposition, the pedigree of the competition. And then obviously to overcome Lazio over the two games, I think, you know, for self-confidence and for self-belief, it'll do the players and the club the world good.
You mentioned there earlier when Brendan left in February, did you feel that you needed something like last night if everyone wasn't on board, that they certainly all are now?
Probably. I can understand that, you know, fans not being too sure and the pedigree of the manager that left and Brendan and what he'd achieved here. So obviously there was a lot of uncertainty around myself, but you know, I have a lot of belief in myself allied with a real good support network behind the scenes that you know, you keep calm and you'll have a few dips here and there, but you stay strong on what you believe in, and you know, so far so good, it's manifesting itself in the right way.
And you mentioned also in terms of, obviously still a couple of months before the January window, are you making inroads and potential targets?
It's too early to say, you know. I haven't had the time to, you know, Nick's got the recruitment department up and running. He's got, you know, a few bits and pieces to do on that, but they're all out working and looking at players as we speak.
Do you know what you want in January in terms of going deep into the competition in the Europa League?
In terms of
what it is
player
you
recruitment?
Do you have an idea in your head what you've been looking
for? Yeah, it's not just obviously going deep into the Europa, it's about, you know, winning the league and winning the competitions that we're in. So if we can find our player to strengthen what we do within, you know, the financial restraint, well, not restraints, but the budget that we work in, and then we'll endeavour to do that as long as they come in to, you know, make us better.
Neil, a man you used to play with at international level, Michael O'Neill, has decided to go back into club management. Do you feel he's got a lot to offer given what he's done with the national team?
Yeah, you know, he's been there a long time, you know, and he's done some remarkable things in Northern Ireland, and I think he's a great example of a manager getting the best out of players each and every time they've performed for him. I think that's exactly what Stoke City need at the minute. You know, I think there's some real quality players there who are probably underperforming for one reason or another. And I think Michael's intelligent enough, tactical enough, and his man management is excellent. So I think it's a great appointment for Stoke City.
He's still going to be in charge for the two games and potentially the playoffs as well. Is that good for the national team to have that continuity?
Absolutely, and it makes common sense. You know, the games are coming up what next week. You know, so it would have been folly to, with the group at such a crucial stage, to, you know, replace Michael altogether. And I think our continuity and familiarity for the players would be very, very important. Obviously,
is that a much more attractive job now for somebody?
Oh, no question. I mean, he is hard act to follow, though. I have to say, you know, it's probably the, you know, best Northern Ireland manager I've had for since Billy Bingham back in the 80s. Remarkable what he did to qualify for the Euros, and again Northern Ireland there having a great group, you know, even in amongst, you know, Germany and Holland, the results have been fantastic and the performances. So it's a great job. I think the IFA have made great strides over the last 10 years under Michael's guidance, so yeah, I think it's a good job for anyone to go into.
So a lot of guys applying or trading the Scottish Premiership that might be interested or might be interested in the IFA. Do you think there is a lot of talent here from Northern Irishmen or people already involved in the...
Well, absolutely, yeah. I mean, we got Austin there who's, you know, worked with Michael for quite a while. And Steve Robinson, obviously. But I think the prime candidate for me would be Tommy Wright. You know, again, somebody who gets the best out of... Squeezes every inch out of the players. He's done a remarkable job at St Johnstone, and he's at that age where, you know, he's got that whole experience of winning and going through bad times as well. I think he would be a prime candidate as far as I was concerned.
You mentioned Stephen Robinson's. You're up against him this weekend. How difficult a game do you think it will be, or he'll make it?
He's having a brilliant season, you know, and Motherwell, he's flexible with his tactics, with his formations. Again, he's had he's another manager who year on year out has to sell his best players and rebuild. And he's been to cup finals with Motherwell, and he has them sitting third or fourth in the league, and they're playing some really good football. So they give Rangers a really difficult game a few weeks ago, so I think we're in for a tough afternoon, and we have to come down off last night very, very quickly.
If you allow me, I'd just like to run through some results for Celtic on the European stage. We've got Celtic 4, Juventus 3, Liverpool 0, Celtic 2, Celtic 1, Barcelona 0, Celtic 1, Manchester United 0.
I played in all of them.
Celtic 2, Barcelona 1, and Celtic 2, Lazio 1, home and away. Excluding Milan in 2007, these are the best results for Celtic in Europe in our modern history. And as you say, you played or managed in every single one of them. So, for you, what is the makings of a successful Celtic team in Europe, and how far do you think this current team can aspire?
Well, I don't want to get carried away, you know, because I know how difficult European football is. I think what this current team have done is they've been really consistent away from home, you know, particularly this season. And that has always been maybe a blot against us, even in the team I played in. We were, you know, fantastic at home and couldn't pick up points away from home. this team can do both now. You know, we've got maximum points in the group at home, which is really important, and you have to maximise the advantage you have here in Glasgow with the support that we have. And from my own experience, it was always a great advantage going into games, no matter who we played. In terms of the away form, you know, this team, like I said, got good experience, but they've got good athleticism. They're able to go the distance in the games now. You know, we get the winner in the 94th, 95th minute, and that's down to the fitness levels more than anything else. And I think we've got a goalkeeper at the minute who makes crucial saves in crucial times in the game, and that gives the whole team, not just the defence, a huge shot in the arm at times. So again, like I said earlier, like I said last night, it's a sum of all parts. There's no, you know, there is outstanding individuals, but it's the team that's the real star at the minute, the way they're playing for each other.
The team in recent years has obviously done excellently domestically, but in European football, picked up some good results, but not really performed at the heights we had in previous years. But like you said, it seems it's been a reinstated of pride in the team on the European front as well as domestically now, with these good results we've got. Have you done anything to try and change the mindset of the players since you came in to give them the belief to perform like that on the European level, not just domestically?
Just ask for more from them in the European games, you know. I think the players can perform better, and they're starting to show that now. That's all. You know, myself, John, Damien, Woodsy, we wanted to, you know, still be dominant domestically, but start to make an imprint in Europe. Because then you get nights like last night, you know, where the whole gravitas of the player, the club, it all changes when you go to a huge club like that and win, and what it does for the confidence and belief. And I've experienced that as a player and experienced that as a manager. So it's good to be able to pass on those small experiences to them and say to them, you can do this. You know, you can really do it. And we had to whip them at half-time as well, say, you know, come on, we didn't start the game well last night. You can play better and be a little bit more aggressive. And we played a lot higher up the pitch for long periods of the second half. And that belief, you know, it's down to them. You know, they came out of the trap second half and I thought for the first 20 minutes of the second half, we were the superior team, and that gives them a lot of confidence.
You know, in terms of team news this weekend, is there a chance Lee Griffiths could feature at all?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
We'll see how he is, you know. It's a possibility. Tom Rodgick, we're hoping, will be back as well. Meggy, we'll have to assess Meggy. Meggy Johnson, obviously, Frimpong, you know, because he's not registered, which we will obviously look at now that we can. We're in the last 32 for the turn of the year. We'll look at that as well with the progression that he's made.
Any injuries from last night?
Well, El Hamed.
Yeah.
So we don't know the prognosis of that just yet. So it's too early to say, because if you scan him now, there'll still be a lot of bleeding around the muscle area. So we'll maybe scan him tomorrow and see the extent of it. But I would doubt he'd be fit for the weekend.
You can ask a question about my news colleagues. It's a pretty grim state of affairs when you go to watch your team abroad and end up getting attacked with someone ending up in a hospital.
Yeah, our best wishes from the club and the players. You know, we just wanted our fans to go there, and in the main they had a good time, but we all want them to come home safe, you know, and it's an ordeal for anyone to have to go through. And I'm sure, you know, on behalf of the club, we wish them a speedy recovery, and maybe we'll get out to see them at some stage as well. Okay?
Cheers.
Bring me sunshine in your smile. Bring me laughter all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love. Bring me sunshine in your smile. Bring me laughter all all the while. In this world where we live, there should be more happiness. So much joy you can give to each brand new bright tomorrow. Make me happy through the years. Never bring me any tears. Let your arms be as warm as the sun from up above. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love, sweet love. Bring me fun, bring me sunshine, bring me love.